All right, welcome back to the channel. Today I'm going to show you how to encrypt all of your cloud data backups using Cryptomator. Cryptomator is a super nice program that does all the encryption locally on the PC before your files get uploaded to the cloud. Now you might be wondering, why the hell is this so important? Well, there used to be two reasons, now there's pretty much only one. The reason for a while back, just even a couple of years ago, is that a lot of these cloud providers were not encrypting their files at rest, so that if a cloud provider would have been compromised in some way, like OneDrive or Google Drive or whatever, and they got hacked, it could have resulted in all of your personal data being stolen, whatever you had uploaded. The reason that you want to do it now, these days, even though they are now doing at-rest encryption on all the major services, is because Microsoft OneDrive does not use zero-knowledge encryption. I couldn't find anything for Google Drive. They don't have a statement one way or the other, so I'm just going to go ahead and presume that they don't have zero-knowledge encryption. And according to Dropbox, they worked with Boxcryptor to implement zero-knowledge encryption. I think it was just earlier this year. But the thing is you want those keys to be in your hands. You don't want those keys to be in someone else's hands. And the thing is, when you use services like Google Drive or OneDrive or whatever, when you accept their terms of service and their privacy policy, you're accepting that they can go through your files. And a lot of people, like if you have like a Gmail account, for example, and you go through and you start seeing like reminders show up on your phone or something like that, that you're like, oh, how could they know about this? Well, it's because they scan your emails, they scan the cloud files that you upload, all that stuff you can send to that. Obviously, there's a big privacy issue with that, though. No one has anything to hide, but still, it's just a matter of, you don't want people just being able to snoop through all of your personal stuff. And also the fact that just because the data is encrypted at rest, with it not being zero knowledge, a compromise could still potentially endanger your data when there's more than just you that holds the keys to that encryption. So today I'm going to show you how to use Cryptomator. It looks super intimidating. It's actually really easy to use. Super awesome program. By the way, in case some of you are probably wondering, why do I sound different and why do I look like shit? I have been super sick the last few days, and so I finally had a little bit of time where the symptoms have kind of subsided a little bit, and I've got a little bit of a window to get this video recorded. I figure I've got maybe 10 minutes left that I can probably talk. If you want to skip around, timestamps are going to be down below, but this will go pretty quick. It's pretty, like I said, it's pretty simple to use. So you'll want to go to Cryptomator's website, download it, install it. We'll open it up here just so you're aware. It depends on the version of Windows that you use or the operating system that you use. But like on Windows, for example, it has to install a third-party tool called WinFSP. So when you go to your control panel to like the add or remove programs, if you see WinFSP in there, it's because Cryptomator uses it. It's not malware, any kind of weird application, spyware, or anything like that. It's completely legitimate. So let's go ahead and go through the process of using this. Like I said, it looks complicated. It's super simple, really easy to use. One thing that I want to point out here is stuff in the settings before we get too in depth here, is when you go to the settings here, you can customize all this stuff. One thing I want you to pay attention to is the volume type. So WinFSP is what Windows uses, and then there's WebDAV. Something to be aware of, WinFSP is good, especially like if you're doing large file sizes, which I presume a lot of you probably are. If the file is 4 gigabytes or over, you cannot use WebDAV to transfer stuff. I noticed there was one version of this that I installed where I couldn't transfer any of my files, and I was trying to figure out what the hell was going on. It's because this protocol has issues transferring anything over 4 gigabytes. So any large files, you need to use this. Now, if you use the mobile apps, you have to use this. And if you use the mobile apps, the cloud provider has to support this protocol. And the only ones are Google Drive, Dropbox, and OneDrive. So for example, if you use sync.com, and you want to use it on mobile, it will not work. So sync.com will work, but it has to be on the desktop. You cannot use it on mobile. So that's just something to be aware of, is the file size and then the restrictions with mobile. So let's go ahead and get started here. So let's go ahead and add Vault. So this, I did a fresh clean install here. When you open it up for the first time, this is what you're gonna see. So let's go ahead and click add Vault. Go ahead. You could open an existing Vault. There's gonna be, I'll show you in a minute, there's files that get created. There's basically like a Vault file that you can open, but in this case, it's a clean computer, clean install. So we're just gonna go ahead and do create new Vault. So create whatever name for your Vault that you want. If you back this up to a cloud provider and then you install it on another computer, the Vault name will carry over. I'm just gonna go ahead and do something simple here. So we'll go ahead and hit next. Where should Cryptomator store the encrypted files of your Vault? Now you could just do local encryption. Like let's say you've got files on your computer. Maybe you share a computer with someone else and you don't want them to be able to access your files. You could do that. Really the use case for this is to use it for cloud, encrypt your cloud backups though. So I'm gonna go ahead and do custom location. Now what I'm gonna do is select the OneDrive folder so I can show you guys how this Vault setup works. Next thing, gotta enter a password. So I'm just gonna go ahead and do a BS password. Keep in mind, you need to make sure this is strong. If you use a weak password, like let's say dictionary word or something, it would be super easy to crack it. Ideally, you want at least 12 characters with a mix of uppercase, lowercase, numbers, and symbols. Next thing it says, you won't be able to access your data without your password. Do you want a recovery key in case you lose your password? I would suggest yes. So let's go ahead and click Create Vault. Now, this is your recovery key here. So make sure you keep this somewhere safe. And it also should be somewhere where someone, you know, like you wouldn't want to like print this out and then put like Cryptomator recovery key and then someone be able to find it, because then what they could do is just open up your computer and decrypt your file. So make sure that you keep this somewhere safe. Okay, so let's go ahead and unlock now. Just before I do that, let me show you what this does. So this is my OneDrive folder. So it created this right here, this test folder. So this is your Vault file. So when you back this up to the cloud, and then let's say you open this up on another computer, what you'll need to do is come in and open this file up in order to open up and access your Vault. The other thing here is you can read this Word doc here, Vault files, this is your Vault storage location. Do not alter any files within this directory or paste any files for encryption into this directory. This is super important because you could completely damage everything and corrupt your Vault and lose data. So don't do it from here. I'll show you how to do it here in just a second. So what we're gonna do is go ahead and unlock the Vault here so I can show you guys how to actually encrypt stuff and have stuff backed up. So here's what it does. So it creates a new, basically like a drive will show up on your computer. So in this case, what you can do is you can come in, I've already created this file here, so I'm just gonna cut and paste that in here so I can show you guys what's going on here. So when you're adding files in here, or you want to copy and paste stuff out, copy and paste stuff in, you need to decrypt the Vault first. And then once you do that, you can do the reveal drive to open it up. Then you can work inside your Vault. So once you have everything that you need done in here, what you can do is just go ahead and close out of everything, go ahead and lock the Vault. Then it will remove it from being able to be accessed, and your files are now encrypted. So if you go to here, so what it does is it comes up with this basically like a naming system here. So it comes up with these random folders within like random folders, and then you have your files. So one of these would be Word file that was already there, and then the other would be the Word file that I just pasted in there. So everything in here gets encrypted. Now, you know, if you were to try and open this up, you're gonna see it would just be a bunch of gibberish. So once that's done, then what you can do is you can go ahead and back all of this stuff up to the cloud. So like if you're using OneDrive, Google Drive, whatever, then just go ahead and let it back stuff up. And like I said, you can access from this stuff from another computer. You can access it from the one you're on. You can access it from mobile. Just make sure. So one other thing I'll mention here real quick, if you lose your password, there's no way to recover this. Again, because this is a zero knowledge encryption system, you are the only one with a key, which means if you forget your password, all of your data is gone permanently. As long as you're willing to work with that, I definitely think there's a lot of benefit to you being the only one that has access to your sensitive files. And especially if you're gonna be backing that stuff up on someone else's server. There's this notion that the cloud is just this, it's this thing out in the ether that you can just magically store and grab stuff out of, but all it is someone else's server on someone else's premises. So that's why it's important that you make sure all of your sensitive stuff is backed up and encrypted and all that stuff. So with that being said, that's really all there is to it. Like I said, it's really easy to use. It looks really complicated, but it's actually just, like I said, it's super easy to use. And if you go back in, like now you can see, oh, I want to unlock it and access my stuff. Then all you have to do is just go ahead and enter your password and you can come in here and change whatever you need, add stuff, take stuff out, whatever. Super simple to use. This is an amazing program. It's open source. It's been in the community for a long time. It's tried and true. I really highly recommend using this. Anyway, that's all I've got. Better wrap the video up before I completely lose my voice. So with that being said, I will see all of you on Friday.